You're watching Utersonneck, and this is part 2 of a tutorial on fixing security cameras that aren't working. In this series, we'll show you step by step how to fix camera problems in a simple way, without any special tools. Even if you've never worked with security cameras before, following these steps will help you get your cameras working again. But before moving forward, keep in mind that you should watch this video only if none of your cameras are working. There's no functional camera available for testing, and all cameras share the same power supply. If at least one camera is working, you should watch part 1. And if none of your cameras are working but each one uses its own individual power supply, then you should watch part 3 instead. If none of your cameras are working and you're not sure what type of power supply they use, check around the DVR area. That's usually where you'll find the power supply or the individual power adapters for the cameras. But if you still can't figure it out, don't worry. We can guide you through it. We offer free support for all kinds of technical issues. All we ask in return is that you subscribe and like the video to help us continue creating content. Our support contact info is in the video description and in a pinned comment. Once you know which video applies to your case, you'll find the links to parts 1 and 3 in the description and in the pinned comment. You should also see on-screen cards for both videos. Just tap or click the one you want to watch. Now, let's take a look at a standard security camera setup. This part is especially helpful if you haven't seen the other videos and don't have experience with security cameras, because it will make it easier to follow the tests we'll be showing. A standard setup usually includes a DVR, which displays, records, and transmits camera footage, not only to a connected monitor, but also to mobile phones and computers through the network. It also includes the cameras themselves, which can vary in brand, model, and technology, ranging from older analog types to more modern HD versions. For video transmission, installers typically use video cables with BNC connectors. These are often coaxial cables, but in some cases people also adapt UTP cables for the job. The system also requires a power supply and power wires with P4 connectors. Each camera can have its own dedicated power supply, or all cameras can share a single one, which may be a honeycomb-style unit or a simple power supply with the wires spliced together. When powered, the cameras capture video and send it to the DVR. Now that you know what a standard security camera installation looks like, let me show you a simple test. This test will help you find out if a camera that isn't working is getting any power at all from the power supply. It's a quick check that will be really useful once you start going through the troubleshooting steps we'll cover in this video. If a camera isn't working and you don't have any special tools, the first thing to check is whether it's receiving power. To do this, cover the camera's light sensor and see if the infrared LEDs turn on. These LEDs handle night vision. The sensor activates the LEDs when the area gets dark, illuminating the scene with infrared light so the camera can capture video even in darkness. Infrared light is invisible to the human eye, but when the LEDs are on, you might see a faint red glow. If you don't see this glow, most phone cameras can still detect the infrared light. This is especially useful at night or in dark areas, because using your phone camera can quickly confirm whether the camera is powered and the infrared LEDs are working. But keep in mind that this may not work with iPhones, as they often have a filter that blocks infrared light. Now that you know the basics, let's start the tests. But before moving forward, make sure the cameras not displaying video aren't being blocked by a DVR setting. For example, some DVRs have a digital mode. When a channel is set to digital, it won't show video from a camera connected to the DVR's BNC input. Make sure there isn't any setting like this enabled on your DVR. Also, check whether the non-working cameras are compatible with the DVR. Some DVRs cannot display video from incompatible cameras. Here's a quick tip. If the cameras were working before and then stopped, they're compatible with your DVR. You only need to check compatibility if it's the first time using these cameras with this DVR. Once the DVR settings are correct and cameras are compatible, we can move on to the tests. The first test you might consider is checking the DVR's video inputs to see if they're working. However, since there's no functional camera available, testing the inputs can be tricky. If the DVR has a composite video output and supports CVBS cameras, you can use the output to test the inputs. Take a short wire, strip the ends, connect one end to the center pin of the DVR's BNC video output, and the other end to the center pin of each DVR BNC input. For each input you connect the wire to, the DVR's interface should appear on the corresponding channel if the input is working and the DVR supports CVBS cameras. If the DVR does not support CVBS cameras or lacks a composite video output, it won't be possible to check the video inputs this way. Since all the cameras are connected to the same power supply, the next step is to check the power supply itself. Most security camera power supplies have an indicator light, usually green or red, that shows when the unit is working. Yours might show a solid light, a blinking light, no light at all, or it might not have an indicator light. Each of these situations requires a slightly different approach, and the results will mean different things. Let's start with a case where the light is blinking or completely off. If the power supply light is off, the first thing to do is make sure it's properly plugged into the wall outlet. Plug it in and check if the cameras start working. If all cameras start working, the problem is solved. If only some cameras start working while others don't, just keep watching. We'll soon show you how to solve the problem when you have at least one working camera. But if none of the cameras start working and the light remains off or keeps blinking, continue with the next tests. The next test helps check whether the power supply itself is faulty. Unplug the power supply from a wall to turn it off. Disconnect one wire from each camera, preferably the positive wire, which is usually red. Plug the power supply back into the outlet. If the indicator light stays off or keeps blinking, the power supply is faulty and needs to be replaced with one that has the same specifications. If the light turns on and stays steady, move on to the next test. The next step is to find out where a short circuit might be, whether it's in a cable, connector, or camera. Keep the power supply on and reconnect the positive wires one by one. If connecting a wire causes the light to turn off or blink, the camera, cable, or connector on that line has a short. Disconnect that wire, mark it, and continue testing the remaining wires if there are more to check. Once all wires are tested, reconnect the wire that showed a short to the power supply to pinpoint the issue. Disconnect the P4 connector from the camera. If the power supply light turns on steadily without blinking, the camera is faulty and needs to be replaced. If the light stays off or blinks, disconnect the positive wire from the P4 connector. If the light then turns on steadily, the P4 connector is faulty and should be replaced. If the light still stays off or blinks, the short is in the power wires. You'll need to repair or replace the cable. Repeat these steps for every wire that shows a short. Once any shorts are resolved, all cameras might start working, or only some, or none at all. If only some cameras start working while others don't, just keep watching. We'll soon show you how to solve the problem when you have at least one working camera. If none of the cameras are working, a practical way to test them is by connecting each camera directly to the power supply and the DVR. Remove each camera from its installation and bring it close to the DVR. Take one of the P4 connectors from a cable and use two wires to connect each camera to the power supply. Make sure to observe the plus and minus signs on the P4 connector. Connect one wire to the positive terminal on the power supply and the other to the negative terminal. Then connect the wires to the corresponding points on the camera's P4 connector. Be careful with the polarity. Connecting the wrong polarity can damage the cameras. If you're unsure, ask someone experienced or contact technical support. Next, connect the first camera to the power supply. Cover its light sensor with your hand to see if the infrared LEDs turn on. If the power supply doesn't have a light and the LEDs don't turn on, the power supply may be faulty and needs replacing. But before replacing the power supply, make sure the cable is assembled correctly and test the other cameras as well. If none of the camera's LEDs turn on, replace the power supply. If some LEDs turn on and others don't, the cameras whose LEDs don't light need to be replaced. Once the infrared LEDs are working, test the cameras directly on the DVR. Use a short wire and strip both ends. Connect one end to the center pin of the camera's BNC connector and the other end to the center pin of a DVR BNC input. Make sure the outer casing of the connectors touch. If the camera is working correctly, its video should appear on the DVR. If no video appears, test the camera on other DVR inputs before deciding it's defective. After identifying functional cameras, you can start testing the cables and connectors. Connect the BNC cables to the DVR inputs and reattach the P4 connector, respecting polarity. Take a functional camera and connect it to the first cable to test. If the video appears on the DVR, the cable is fine, and you can install a permanent camera on it. If no video appears, cover the camera's light sensor to see if the infrared LEDs turn on. If LEDs don't light, the camera isn't receiving power. Check the P4 connector and power wires and replace if necessary. If LEDs do light, check the video cable and BNC connectors. Once cable issues are resolved, the functional camera's video should appear on the DVR and you can install the permanent camera. Repeat this process for each cable until all camera issues are resolved. Once all cables and cameras have been tested, your security system should be fully operational. If any cameras still don't work after following these steps, double-check the installation and connections. You may also need to replace the faulty cameras. Remember, this tutorial is designed so that even beginners can fix their cameras without using any special tools. By carefully following each step, you should be able to identify and solve most problems when all cameras share a power supply. If you have any questions, encounter a situation not covered in this video, or need extra guidance, don't hesitate to contact our free technical support. All the contact details are in the video description and in a pinned comment. We're happy to help you with any technical issue. To continue learning and improving your security system, make sure to subscribe to the channel, turn on notifications, and like the video. This helps us keep creating high-quality tutorials just like this one. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video. God bless you.